every motion you make.
It never goes away. It's going to be in there. You know, the sand is your soul. Is that what you're trying to say, Pa? Sand is the spirit itself,
yeah,
the eternal part.
You just flip
it. But it just moves around and changes form and places.
Flip it. Yeah, that's all I said. It's just flipping it. That's a good analogy, man.
Damn good.
I never thought of an hourglass.
Me neither.
I like that session myself because I never thought of anything like that. That's a good analogy. And he's showing me the hourglass, you know, like, he can make it appear in his hand, you know, probably just by
long. Thinking it.
Yeah, he just, and this is, look, you know, and then he's doing this, but, you know, the sand's moving fast, you know, he's showing me the analogy, you know, he's doing it right, you know.
It's like, you know, I mean, a lot of people say, you know, I was thinking about, something came to mind about fame and of this world and whatnot, you know, so I'll speak that. You know, about like, people always say death makes people more legendary. People die early, like in your case, Pop, you know, and the many others, you know, people die and then all of a sudden they become more famous because of that, you know. I mean, you think some spirits, maybe even yourself that have gone through that way, actually planned that out before they incarnated, to have that, I assume that it was sort of planned to leave the physical world at a particular point in order for more things to take hold. You know what I'm saying?
I think he's saying like this, you know, that, you know, it was never misunderstood to him why he died once he crossed over.
Yeah, it was meant to be. But was that planned out before you even incarnated in that as this last life? You know, I've heard about that before. I was just seeing you giving your input on that. Was that part of your plan that
he before? He don't know.
You don't know?
He don't even know, you know.
All right.
He said, but he said, listen, that when he did die, that the thing was that the love that he received, you know, because he crossed over, you know, it was more beneficial on that side than it was on this side anyway.
I could imagine that. Because on this side, you're not always receiving. You know, you don't. I guess you don't get it all. You don't feel it all the time like you can there.
He feels like an angel. You know?
Well, everybody's an angel. I mean, I think that's something I believe. Everybody has the capability to be an angel.
He's like laughing and going, "I like you, Matt. I like you."
This is how I treat people, Pa. This is how I am, man. Mm-hmm. I don't judge people. Like me and Jeremy were talking about the other day about.
He's not like both of y'all.
We were talking about, like, you know, like so-called bad people in this world doing so-called bad things, robbing people, killing people, and whatnot. Look, we understand that. You know, we try to understand everybody. This, I mean, even they are angels. I think that too. You know, even people like that are angels in a way for other people. But I don't know. That's why I was just thinking about that. Don't mind me running my mouth a lot. But I'm enjoying this. I'm learning. You're teaching me a lot, man. You know. But
you don't even think about the other life, he says, you know, anymore, like this, this one, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because he receives it, you know what I'm saying? It's more like it comes down upon him like a shining light, you know, like he can walk and feel it, you know, you don't have to think about it because all the stuff he wants to ignore or whatever, it just automatically happens, you see what I'm saying? But he does have an obligation also, he feels, in a way that, you know, like a lot of people in the past said, look, if they could come back, he'd come back. He's just trying to come back, you know, from the other world and wave his hand in the air, you know what I'm saying, and tell people, you know, Tupac is back, you know, Tupac is back, you know, that's what he's saying, you know, come, you know, he's saying, us.
What about?
We're the ones, we're gonna help people, man. We're gonna help people. We're gonna let the other side come through, you know. And us doing this is he's promoting us.
Well,
I mean,
damn well appreciate that.
But
oh,
I want to say something to Tupac, man. I just want to say, man, that I have high respect for you, man, because like you know, when I listen to your music, I just being a writer myself, I get chill bumps, man, when I hear a lot of your songs, you know, and that's a good thing, you know.
Well, you outputted a lot of creativity, man. That's for damn sure. Get a creative mind. I feel that.
Poet, you know, he's like Shakespeare. You know what I'm saying? Tupac, you're like Shakespeare, man. You know, I don't want
Shakespeare in the hood.
I'm excited. Yeah,
so that's what I think of it. Like, you know, like people think of him, you know, people think of you like that. Like, you know, like, you know, like he was
laughing.
A poet and this and that. You know how people think, man.
He's laughing, doing like this.
Because you like me, man. Because that's when people tell me, like, Pop, look, when I write stuff too, man. Sometimes I can't even read it myself. Sometimes I start tripping and ripping at the pieces. It's hard for me. And then when people say, oh, it's good, it's hard for me. I start going like this too and covering my face. I can't deal with it sometimes because it makes me think of my own self too much and my negative aspects. Maybe they're not really negative, but enough about me. But it relates. I can see what you're saying. Yeah, that's humbleness. I like. I try to be humble too, man. It all serves a purpose, man.
He just has a big grin on his face. He's going to let us go, I think, man.
All right, man. All right.
Listen, he says he hopes he did us a favor, you know.
Well, you did, man. You did. I mean...
He said you're doing me a favor.
Well, that's no problem at all, man. I wish I could have asked better questions, I mean, but I think what we did is it will help people, you know. Because, you know, people that might see this, I was going to say... This might get them thinking more about what really happens in life and the universe, you know? Might be thinking more about things, you know? Might live their lives a little different things than mine.
I'm going to tell you that, I want to say this and stress this much more, you know, that this is not easy to do. This, you know, this is heavy on my mind and body. I sleep more. You know, it takes a lot of energy out of me to do this kind of thing, and you know, when people like Tupac want to come through, I'm very excited to do that. But it wears me out, and I want you to know that people want to say it's not real or whatever, like let them deal with the ridicule, because I get it, I've gotten it today. So I just wanted to say that again. You know.
Yeah, I mean, but. Screw it, you know, because look, when you know something is real, you know, it's, you know what truth is and you know what falsity is, and you can feel it in your gut, intuition,
yeah.
You know, and this is some real stuff here. I mean, you know, like some people might say, oh, people like that, people like Pac or whoever might not, would have never talked to you because you're nobody. Or whatnot, you know what I mean? You know, why would they take the time to speak to you? But it doesn't matter over on the other side. You know, they know if there's an opening to come through to speak. You know,
yeah,
they do it.
There's only a handful of us anyway, and I don't think they're caught up on the other side about the things that we're caught up on over here anymore. You know?
No, not at all.
Yeah.
Well, man, like I just want to say, I appreciate this again, man. You know. And,
yeah,
and
thank you
for letting people know on the other side about us too, man. I really, really appreciate that and everything, man. And you know, we'll look forward to seeing you again, man. Anytime, man. Anytime. All right.
Starstruck. That's
yeah.
Up, man.